In this video, we aim to help you find relief from the discomfort and pain of diabetic neuropathy without relying solely on medication. Diabetic neuropathy is a common complication that affects many diabetics. It can manifest as numbness, tingling, or burning sensations in your hands and feet. This condition not only causes physical discomfort, but also significantly impacts your daily life. Constant pins and needles in your extremities while trying to perform simple tasks like walking or holding a cup of coffee, disrupted sleep, and the anxiety that comes with it can all become overwhelming. Moreover, the loss of sensation increases the risk of unnoticed injuries, which can lead to serious infections if left untreated. The problem occurs due to prolonged high blood sugar levels, which damages nerves over time. High glucose levels impair nerve function by causing inflammation and disrupting their ability to transmit signals effectively. Additionally, poor circulation further exacerbates nerve damage as it deprives them of essential nutrients. But fortunately, it's possible to slow the progression of neuropathy, improve circulation, potentially reduce pain and discomfort, and as a result, lift your overall well-being. But before we get into it, can you do us a favor and like this video? Ring the bell for future notifications and make sure you subscribe to Diabetics Talk for more practical diabetes information. Plus, stick around to find out how you can get not one, not two, but three free gifts. Also, don't forget to check out exclusive Diabetics Talk merchandise from our store and sign up as a member to get full access to the Food, Health, and You Complete Implementation System documentary and more. Okay, let's get into it. Number 5, topical treatments. Topical treatments may provide localized relief for diabetic neuropathy. The most popular option is capsaicin cream. Derived from chili peppers, capsaicin cream is rubbed into the skin on the affected areas. It works by desensitizing the nerves and reducing pain sensations. A 2016 clinical trial found that a 30-minute treatment with capsaicin patches provided modest pain relief and improved sleep quality. But be sure to follow the instructions carefully, as it can cause a burning sensation. Likewise, lidocaine patches may provide localized pain relief by blocking pain signals. Arnica gel, derived from the arnica plant, has well-known anti-inflammatory properties and may help reduce pain and swelling through gentle massage. Certain essential oils, such as lavender, peppermint, and chamomile, also have an analgesic and anti-inflammatory properties and are used by diluting a few drops into a carrier oil, such as coconut, olive, or jojoba oil, and gently massaging it into the affected areas. And for some people, simply applying a warm or cold compress can provide relief. A warm bath also does the trick for many people, increasing blood circulation and reducing pain. Number 4, physical therapies. Acupuncture and acupressure show great results for many people. Acupuncture is an ancient Chinese technique that's increasingly being adopted in Western medicine. It involves the insertion of thin needles into specific points of the body, which may sound painful, but it's often not noticeable at all. By targeting specific points related to nerve pathways, acupuncture may help reduce neuropathic pain and improve nerve function. In a 2007 study, people with peripheral neuropathy received acupuncture for 1 year, with 76% showing improvement in nerve conduction. Acupressure is similar but utilizes finger pressure instead of needles. Applying firm pressure to specific points can stimulate nerve pathways, promote blood circulation, and alleviate pain. Acupressure can be performed by a trained practitioner or self-administered once you've learned how. Exploring physical therapies is well worth considering, but go into it with an understanding that treatments don't always work for every person. Ensure that you seek treatment from a licensed and experienced acupuncturist or acupressure practitioner who understands diabetic neuropathy. In addition, other therapies like massage may also provide relief. Massage can improve blood circulation, reduce muscle tension, and promote relaxation. Again, look for a licensed massage therapist who has experience in working with neuropathy to ensure a safe and tailored approach. Number 3, herbal remedies and supplements. Certain herbal remedies and supplements may improve symptoms of diabetic neuropathy. While these remedies are not meant to replace medical treatments, in some cases they can complement them and provide relief. Other options to consider include alpha-lipoic acid, benfotiamine, and acetyl-L-carnitine. Alpha-lipoic acid, for example, is a powerful antioxidant that is effective for some people. According to a study in the Journal of Biomedical Diabetes Research, alpha-lipoic acid seems to delay or reverse peripheral diabetic neuropathy through its multiple antioxidant properties. However, it can interact with certain medications, and long-term use may pose a risk of liver toxicity for some people. So definitely talk to a professional who knows your situation before going down this route. In a 2006 study, researchers found a daily dose of 600 milligrams to provide the optimal risk-to-benefit ratio. Now, let's turn to herbs. Certain herbs may help to reduce pain and other symptoms. For example, evening primrose oil is known for its anti-inflammatory properties, skullcap is used to alleviate neuropathic pain, and St. John's wort may help with multiple symptoms. It's important to note that all of these can interact with certain medications or have side effects, so it's crucial to consult with a trusted professional. They can provide guidance on appropriate dosages, potential interactions, and help you make informed decisions based on your specific situation. Before we get to number 2, how about those free gifts? Discover an entire world of diabetes-fighting foods with our new book, 10 Incredible Foods That Reduce Blood Sugar. Plus, you'll discover the real reason why type 2 diabetes, obesity, and heart disease are increasing at an alarming rate, and find out what really works when it comes to preventing these illnesses by watching our free diabetes-fighting documentary. Plus, get a free recipe book, Amazing Alternatives to Rice, Pasta, and Bread, which contains over 50 delicious and easy-to-prepare recipes that the whole family will love. These gifts are free and waiting for you to grab them in the description box below. Now, back to our video. Number 2, regular exercise. Not only does exercise benefit overall health, but it can also improve symptoms of neuropathy. Exercise stimulates blood flow, which is crucial for nourishing nerves and reducing neuropathic pain, numbness, and tingling. Plus, consistent exercise helps to keep blood sugar down, as well as weight management. Excess weight can exacerbate neuropathy symptoms, so shedding extra pounds can provide significant relief. Now, what types of exercise are good? Start with low-impact exercises and gradually increase intensity and duration as your fitness improves. Walking, swimming, cycling, or dancing are excellent choices. Swimming and aquaticize are particularly valuable depending on your stage of progression and the general condition of your body, because higher-impact exercise can be too much if you already have neuropathy. That said, strength training builds muscle, improves balance, and significantly improves blood sugar control. So if it's within your ability, using resistance bands or weights can be extremely beneficial. Finally, we have flexibility and balance exercises. Stretching, yoga, and tai chi all improve flexibility, balance, and coordination. They not only help with neuropathy symptoms, but may also reduce the risk of falls, which are a major concern with peripheral neuropathy. Plus, they have low barrier to entry, are calming and centering, and are simply enjoyable activities. When starting out with any new exercise, take it slow and listen to your body. Begin with shorter durations and gradually increase the intensity and duration as your tolerance improves. And remember, consistency is what matters. So aim for 15 to 30 minutes per day of whatever level you're at. And if you're not currently active, consult with your healthcare professional first. Number 1, eat well. Maintaining a healthy and balanced diet is essential. What you eat directly impacts blood sugar levels, nerve health, and potential complications like heart disease. If you already have neuropathy, every choice makes a difference. to slow down the progression of neuropathy, reduce inflammation, or, on the other hand, to accelerate the damage and trigger other diseases. We have many other videos on this topic, but for a simple plan, limit refined carbohydrates like bread, pasta, and pastries, essentially anything with refined flour, as these trigger inflammation and spike blood sugar. Choose whole grains, legumes, and vegetables as your primary sources of carbohydrates. These complex carbs are digested more slowly, resulting in a gradual release of glucose into the bloodstream. Plus, whole foods come with a mix of antioxidants, vitamins, minerals, fiber, and other micronutrients that are going to support your body. Include healthy fats such as avocados, nuts, seeds, and olive oil. If you like animal products, go for pasture-raised or free-range eggs, grass-fed meats, and wild-caught fish. Foods that are produced in more natural ways. With access to sunshine, real food, and free of antibiotics, stress hormones, and contamination that comes with mass-produced animal products. Next, one of the most important steps is to minimize sugar intake. Stay away from sugary beverages, sweets, and processed foods that contain added sugars. These are often the cause of the pain and result in rapid blood sugar fluctuations that worsen neuropathy symptoms. Drink plenty of water throughout the day to maintain proper hydration, as well as herbal teas. Dehydration can exacerbate neuropathic symptoms, so it's essential to stay adequately hydrated. Finally, monitor your blood sugar levels regularly. People respond differently to food, exercise, medication, and supplements. Our physiological constitutions are different, and while science can give us broad strokes of information, blood glucose monitoring is extremely valuable for understanding your own body. This is especially true for diabetics, where it's common to see person A eat a sweet potato and experience an insignificant blood sugar increase, while person B spikes off the chart and causes real damage to their body. Understanding how your body responds to different foods can be one of the most empowering and valuable steps that any diabetic can take. Okay, so to recap, our 5 natural ways to relieve diabetic neuropathy. Number 5, topical treatments. Number 4, physical therapies. Number 3, herbal remedies and supplements. Number 2, regular exercise. And number 1, eat well and monitor your blood sugar. We hope you enjoyed this video. Let us know in the comments if you have any questions, comments, or tips to share with others in the community. Make sure to subscribe to our channel and hit that bell button. And don't forget, you can claim your free gifts by clicking the link in the description below or visiting us at diabeticstalk.com. We want to keep making informative, research-based videos for you. So if you gained value from this video and would like more of it, you can send us a super thanks by clicking the thanks button at the bottom of the video. We're Diabetics Talk, and it's our mission to bring you the best tips and tricks to help you fight diabetes. Thanks for watching. We hope you're having a diabetes-fighting day.